The miracle man of the World Trade Center has got to be John McLoughlin. He is a New York City Port Authority police officer, and the guys who rescued him say John McLoughlin was on the 82nd floor of this building of the World Trade Center, one of the towers, and he rode that building down into the rubble from the 82nd floor. He was rescued just about an hour or so ago, apparently with only a broken leg. There was some consideration that they would have to amputate that leg. Some amputation equipment was brought in. It was decided that they did not, so he has been removed. His wife, I'm told, is 8 months pregnant. One of the miracle rescue stories that is going on here this morning. One of the officers, I'm told, actually told his rescuers that he was on the 82nd floor when the building collapsed, and that he rode the building down from the 82nd floor.
Eric, we were just struck by something you said. We want you to repeat this to make sure we heard it right. You said someone was up on the 80-somethingth floor and rode the crash down?
Yes, that's the story that we're hearing here. It hasn't been confirmed, but apparently when this police officer, one of the two Port Authority police officers, was pulled out of the wreckage, he was saying that he wrote it down.
He's saying that he was on 82nd floor and somebody was asking him repeatedly, are you sure, are you sure, are you sure?
He said yes.
And he swore up and down. He was on the 82nd floor and he wrote everything down. He wrote the building down. He went down with the building.
Wow. And that, not only that, his wife's pregnant?
His wife was 8 months pregnant, and she was calling repeatedly to his boss, and miraculously, within 3 minutes, they pulled him out.
And this man's, he's alive.
Some injuries to his legs, mm-hmm. but he seems to be okay.
And that is amazing. Maybe just a broken leg if this fellow, that Port Authority police officer was able to ride that building all the way down from the 82nd floor.
All right. Sean, thanks very much.
Unbelievable. What a great cause for hope, though.
The most miraculous story, that of a Port Authority policeman named John McLoughlin. He was on the 82nd floor of one of the towers when the building collapsed. He says he rode the debris to the ground, and incredibly, he only suffered two broken legs and some broken ankles, but other than that, he is fine. The most miraculous story to date, a Port Authority cop named John McLoughlin. He was on the 82nd floor of one of the towers when the building collapsed. He says he rode the debris to the ground, and incredibly, he only suffered two broken legs.
Nicolas Cage stars in World Trade Center as Sergeant John McLoughlin, one of two Port Authority police officers who miraculously survived.
One of the things that I learned from talking with John was, clearly, how did you survive this? Where did you have to go to survive a situation like this? And it's no secret that it's always an overwhelming, you know, experience to meet someone who's been tested to that extent, the way John McLoughlin has been.
They used some of the rescue workers in the filming. The guys that dug us out were there kind of redigging us out again in the film. They used the people and used the information from the people that were the rescue workers that were there that day, what they saw, what they did, and how they did it, and then had them doing those roles in the movie.
One of the most amazing stories we have today is that one of the Port Authority officers who was rescued from beneath the debris, he told his rescuers that he rode the building down, that he was on the 82nd floor of the World Trade Center tower when it just imploded into itself, and he just rode the building down, as incredible as that sounds, suffering only a broken leg. His wife is 8 months pregnant. The miracle man of this incident, though, of course, has to be police officer John McLoughlin of the Port Authority Police Department. He told rescuers when he was rescued a couple of hours ago that he was on the 82nd floor of one of the towers, and he rode that tower down when it imploded on itself. He landed in between the two towers in what was a huge ornamental plaza, basically with just a broken leg. At one point, they thought they would have to amputate that leg, but they did not. John McLoughlin, gloriously alive.
Wilhelm Minow and John McLoughlin are two Port Authority police officers that went down to Ground Zero, and they went up in these buildings to save as many lives as they could.
An entire, how many story building just came down on top of you guys?
Two buildings. We were hit by both buildings.
That's 220 stories.
How many hours were you guys down there, do you know, trapped?
Well, yeah, I was trapped 13 hours. They got me out around 11 p.m. that evening. Okay. They found us at 8, took 3 hours to extract me out. And then Sarge was buried about 15 feet back from me.
I was buried for 22 hours.
You were buried for 22 hours?
I got me out the following morning.
And of course, the miracle story of one police officer, John McFarland, who rode this building down. He was on the 82nd floor of the building. When he rode it down to the bottom, he was found pinned under some concrete. They thought he would have to amputate his leg. They did not. Port Authority Officer John McLoughlin, the miracle man of this day here, he, according to the rescuers, rode that building down from the 82nd floor. When he was rescued and pulled out from underneath the debris, he said he was on the 82nd floor when that building imploded, and he rode that building all the way down to what is left of the World Trade Center. The miracle man of this story, he went down about 82 stories or so and rode the whole World Trade Center down and survived with leg injuries.
I couldn't even believe at that point that I was alive, and I survived that, and there was nothing above me.
Do you have any sense for how you fell from the 22nd floor, which is the way you've identified it? Mm-hmm. You landed on a rubble that most people think was about 7 stories high.
Okay.
So we're talking about a 15-story free fall on, theoretically, a piece of concrete. That's why they call you the 9/11 surfer.
He was in the North Tower and says he rode down more than 15 stories of concrete and falling debris.
They'd made it down as far as the 22nd floor.
And then just felt the railing just start to shake and this loud, loud noise from above. I thought of my wife, my unborn child. I've never experienced jumping out of a plane, but I guess falling, we're jumping out of a plane, that feeling of just riding the air and getting knocked around and riding, you know, that surfing kind of feeling was what I was experiencing.
We have animation to show this harrowing ride that you had. You were on the 64th floor, you evacuated down to the 22nd, and then fell essentially to the 4th floor. The name of the documentary is The 9/11 Surfer. Feels like an odd word.
Yes, very odd. I've heard about the urban legends. I've always read about it, and my wife was like, that's you, you know. And they pretty much dubbed it that on Discovery and the show, and because they did a study on it, and they said that basically how I survived was probably in this pocket of air or this uplift of wind, or the way I described the fall.
So
I guess 9/11 Surfer is...
You said urban legend, which it's true. A lot, some people are skeptical. And you said if you had heard this story, you might have been skeptical as well.
Of course. I'm an engineer. I have just believe in science and facts. I went through it, so I know what I went through. And if I hadn't, someone told me the story, I'd be skeptical also.
It's about the sensation of falling. Can you still remember that to this day?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Every moment of that. Free falling. I, the final impact, the final flash of when I landed, it was that I don't know. It was either when I actually landed and got knocked unconscious, or during the fall I got hit with something and got knocked unconscious. But a split second later, I opened up my eyes and I just felt, I thought I was dead. And then I started to cough, feel pain. And I said, I can't believe, I couldn't believe at that point. I looked up and there was nothing above me. The building was gone. So I couldn't even believe it myself at that point.
And I was carrying this baby, and there was nothing I could do. And I just watched the whole thing happen right in front of me. And, you know, it was just a feeling of just hopeless, helplessness, really.
It must still be so hard to see that image of the tower falling, knowing that you were inside.